All right, here we are for round number two. We're on the draw, and this hand looks fine. It would be nice if we had another green source, just because that turns on more of our deck, but Fatal Push into Grimflare, into whatever. Yeah, there's the Nissa that we can't cast. That was what I was worried about, but again, can't really mulligan this hand. I'm just going to take the Dread Wanderer here. Two damage is not that much, and Zombies has much scarier creatures than Dread Wanderer, who comes back anyway. If they just pass with no play, I might consider killing it, but no, I'm happy to kill off a Relentless Dead. That's just fine. Well, it can't return. Oh, God. All right. Well, that's not great. Please, no Dark Salvation. That looks like a Dark Salvation. Yeah. Things are going to get tough here. We have mono uncastables. Ah, another double green card to add to our fine collection. So hopefully they don't have a removal spell and Kalidus will just take over the game, but I'm not super optimistic about that. Alright, so that Traverse at least gives us another green source later, maybe. Oh, that's another Dark Salvation. That is going to end the game very quickly. I don't think we have any outs. Well, I think our opening hand was fine, but we actually didn't draw a spell we could cast in the first five turns of the game, so that didn't work out great. Anyway, sideboarding against Zombies. I like that one. I like Obnixilis just because you need to kill their stuff. Yeheni's Expertise is clearly fantastic, and Grasp of Darkness is great. Dissenter's Deliverance doesn't do much. I like Liliana a lot. I think you can cut a Tireless Tracker, just because it's a little slow, and cutting down on some number of Nissa is probably correct. On the draw, I think I'm going to have no Nissas in my deck. On the play, a couple is acceptable. And one more cut. Could probably cut a Gear Hulk, but I'm not sure if that's the right thing. Yeah, I'm going to cut a Gear Hulk, actually. Well, all the removal that kills this is actually not very good at killing it if it is really big. Maybe cut a Grimflare. That seems so tough to... Yeah, actually, it makes sense with all the Yeheni's. Or maybe cut a Winding Constrictor with all the Yeheni's expertises. But we left in all of our counter cards, basically. I'll cut a Rishkar, actually. That's fine. I don't love Rishkar that much anyway. All right, let's give this a try. All right, here we are for game two. We get to go first. All right. Well, this hand is also pretty good, also vulnerable to getting mana screwed the same way the last one did. Although this time at least we have a better curve. And we're on the play, so both of those things matter. I'm definitely just going to go ahead and jam the Grimflare here. If they want to Fatal Push it, they can Fatal Push it. That's fine. Ooh, Transgress. That's rough. Huh. Haven't seen that one out of Zombies before. I mean, obviously they mostly have it in their sideboard, but I think most people don't bring it in, so that's interesting. I think it is probably good to bring in if you know what's, you know, if you know that my deck is trying to transform into a controlling deck, it seems like a good idea to bring it in. I just haven't seen many people do that before, so plus one smart point for my opponent. I'm just going to jam the Ballista here. It's going to be quite strong if they play. It gates them from playing one toughness, guys. Oh my god. Wow, punished. That is also one I have never seen out of Zombies in the post-board games. So they're also going with sort of a controlling route, it looks like. Well, can't really just sit around with them having a Liliana, so Kalidus it is, I guess. And we did draw a Fatal Push, so we can kill something if they play something. Lord of the Accursed. Okay. Traverse. Doesn't do much. I guess I'm gonna just go ahead and attack Liliana. Yeah, that's fine. I wasn't gonna block if they attack because of the Dark Salvation. So I would rather just get my attack in while I can. Gain my one life. I don't want to cast Traverse here because we actually have these two cards together add up for Delirium. So I don't really want to waste the Traverse when there's a good chance it'll be online soon. And we don't really have a good plan for the extra land anyway. Okay, do I want to play the forest? I think that's actually an interesting question. I'm certainly going to attack Liliana. I assume that our guy is getting grasped, yeah. Man, our opponent's cards have just lined up so well this game. Yeah, I guess I'll play the forest. We could save it for a whatchamacallit, but I don't think that's a good play. A Tireless Tracker. But I think drawing the outs to draw like Green Gear Hulk or Obnixilus or something are just too strong. Oh my goodness. Alright. This one maybe I should have held, actually. So we really have to draw a Never to Return at this point. Boy, if I'd held that Walking Ballista, things would have worked out a lot better this game. Could have played it for a larger number, and then Liliana would actually be in jeopardy. Yeah, we can't beat the Liliana emblem here. I guess we could go Expertise. No, we don't even have enough mana. All right. Well, our opponent's draw lined up very well, and ours did not. So, like I've said, I've had some difficulty with this matchup, so I'm experimenting with different ways to interact. The Yeheni's Expertise was very bad there, but against most of the Zombies players I've played against, it seems like it would have been good. This my opponent seems to have successfully anticipated the plan that I was going to be on, and it worked out well. Like, if this was a Gonti or something, this game would have been a lot easier, I think, or would have maybe been more winnable. Anyway, we will be back for round 3.